Please all stand. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Behold the handmaid of the Lord. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. And the Word was made flesh
and dwelt among us.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God,
that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech you, O Lord, your grace into our hearts, that we to whom the incarnation of Christ, your Son, was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Mary, help of Christians, pray for us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated for a while. Good morning. Together with our personal intentions, we also include the following. For the gift of life and birthday intentions of Franz Nancy Quijada, Joshua Kabornay, CJ Messina, Gabriel Anipot, Mirna Sapno, Fiolo Parages, Zedric Mark, Cyril Cathedral, Nico Tuadles, and Jaden De Los Reyes. For the healing, recovery, and good health of Christian Lars. For the intentions of Adrian, Audrey, Alan Michael, and Joseph. For the eternal repose of the souls of Maximo Velarde, Ronali, Jeremiah, Rogelio Torrefiel, for the eternal repose of Father George Militante, Mercedes Secretaria, for the soul of Pedrito Buton on his first death anniversary, and for the soul of Saludita Buton, for the souls of Chodora, Zinaida, Edgar, Eufemio Sr., Francisco, Alicia, Pedro, Alexander, Salud, Baltazar, Margaret, Miguel, Libertito, Jake, Joaquin, and Raul. And for the eternal repose of the souls in purgatory. Please all stand.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who made the bishop Saint Cyril of Alexandria an invincible champion of the divine motherhood of the most blessed Virgin Mary, grant, we pray, that we who believe she is truly the Mother of God may be saved through the incarnation of Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Genesis. Abram was very rich in livestock, silver and gold. Lot, who went with Abram, also had flocks and herds and tents, so that the land could not support them if they stayed together. Their possessions were so great that they could not dwell together. There were quarrels between the herdsmen of Abram's livestock and those of Lot's. At this time, the Canaanites and the Perizzites were occupying the land. So Abram said to Lot, "Let there be no strife between you and me, or between your herdsmen and mine. For we are kinsmen. Is not the whole land at your disposal? Please separate from me. If you prefer the left, I will go to the right. If you prefer the right, I will go to the left." Lot looked about and saw how well watered the whole Jordan plain was as far as Zoar, like the Lord's own garden, or like Egypt. This was before the Lord had destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah. Lot, therefore, chose for himself the whole Jordan plain and set out eastward. Thus they separated from each other. Abram stayed in the land of Canaan, while Lot settled among the cities of the plain, pitching his tents near Sodom. Now the inhabitants of Sodom were very wicked in the sins they committed against the Lord. After Lot had left, the Lord said to Abram, "Look about you, and from where you are, gaze to the north and south, east and west. All the land that you see, I will give to you and your descendants forever. I will make your descendants like the dust of the earth. If anyone could count the dust of the earth, your descendants too might be counted. Set forth and walk about in the land through its length and breadth, for to you I will give it. Abram moved his tents and went on to settle near the terebinth of Mamre, which is at Hebron. There he built an altar to the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
He who does justice will live in the presence of the Lord. He who walks blamelessly and does justice, who thinks the truth in his heart and slanders not with his tongue.
He who does justice will live in the presence of the Lord.
Who harms not his fellow man, nor takes up a reproach against his neighbor, by whom the reprobate is despised, while he honors those who fear the Lord.
He who does justice will live in the presence of the Lord.
Who lends not his money at usury and accepts no bribe against the innocent, he who does these things shall never be disturbed.
He who does justice will live in the presence of the Lord.
Please all stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not give what is holy to dogs, or throw your pearls before swine, lest they trample them underfoot and turn and tear you to pieces. Do to others whatever you would have them do to you. This is the law and the prophets. Enter through the narrow gate, for the gate is wide and the road broad that leads to destruction, and those who enter through it are many. How narrow the gate and constricted the road that leads to life, and those who find it are few." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning, brothers and sisters. On the road to life, which way will we choose? The easier one or the more difficult? Our Lord Jesus in today's Gospel teaches us to choose the better way. The wide and broad way symbolizes a life that is without any responsibility, all laziness, and with much revelry, and at times, vices. Many would like to choose this kind of passage since it is an easier and a much taken one. That road or gate, according to Jesus, will lead towards destruction, darkness, and eventually death. On the other hand, the narrow and better gate consists of a life that is filled with much restraint, discipline, hard work, and service. And for our Lord Jesus, this is the road that will lead us to life and light. Therefore, we need to choose the narrow and better road even though not many will take it. It is a road that is least traveled. It is a gate that only few would like to enter in. According to a proverb, it is better to walk alone than with a crowd going in the wrong direction. Today we remember Saint Cyril of Alexandria, Bishop and Doctor of the Church. He is one who chose the narrow and better gate in his life, especially when he was in constant debate against the certain heresies of his time. He was one of those who defended Mary as the Theotokos, or God-bearer, at the Council of Ephesus. He was a great spokesman for orthodoxy and was noted for his Christological doctrines. He also supported the growth of Egyptian monasticism, leading many people closer to God through contemplation, prayer, and community life. My dear brothers and sisters, learning from the lives of our fellow Christians and followers of the Lord who have gone ahead of us, we realized that we are not alone in taking the narrow gate. Many of us experience suffering and trials as we continue to live our Christian lives daily, but we never waver because we follow a God who never leaves us, who always blesses us with His grace and strength, and whose love guides us. As Christians, we too have a mission of leading many others to this road towards life and light. May our own lives become beacons of light to those in darkness. May our own examples become guideposts so that more and more people today can experience God's never-failing love and that the world be filled with hope in the risen Lord Jesus. Christ promises that the narrow gate leads to life. Let us come to our Heavenly Father with the trust and confidence of the prayer our Lord taught us. Lord, open to us the door of grace.
Lord, open to us the door of grace,
that the leaders of the church may guide the flock to the door that leads to life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, open to us the door of grace,
that as a community, we may treat one another with respect, consideration, and love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, open to us the door of grace,
that we may carry out God's will by our compassionate dealings with others. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, open to us the door of grace,
that the sick and those suffering from various illnesses may find strength and healing. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, open to us the door of grace,
that the faithful departed may be raised with Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, open to us the door of grace. Heavenly Father, create within us sincerity of heart, so that we may love and respect others as you treasure them. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive, O Lord, the sacrifice of conciliation and praise, and grant that cleansed by its action, we may make offering of a heart pleasing to you, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For although you have no need of our praise, yet our thanksgiving is itself your gift, since our praises add nothing to your greatness, but profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. And so in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Thank you. The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the help of Christians, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, Saint Cyril of Alexandria, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Jesus taught us to call God our Father, and so we have the courage to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, bring me back to your most holy body and blood from all my sins and from every evil. Keep me always faithful to your commandments, and never let me depart from you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and
my soul shall be healed.
The body and blood of Christ.
Thank you.
spiritual communion. O Jesus, I turn toward the holy tabernacle, where you live hidden for love of me. I love you, O my God, I cannot receive you in holy communion. Come nevertheless and visit me with your grace. Come spiritually into my heart, purify it, sanctify it, render it like unto your own. Amen.
Everlasting.
Let us pray. Renewed and nourished by the sacred body and precious blood of your Son, we ask of your mercy, O Lord, that what we celebrate with constant devotion may be our sure pledge of redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass has been offered. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.